Hi guys, welcome to LiTime's video. Today we'll show you the method of series and parallel connection. Please prepare the following things like two batteries, balancer, two copper busbar, wrenches, MA terminal bolts, two AWG PVC wire, red and black, and the insulation gloves. Before we start, we want to share some prerequisites with you. Please make sure the batteries meet all the conditions below. First, they are batteries with the same battery type, capacity, voltage, and BMS. Second, they are from the same brand, LiTime is the same as the AmperTime. Third, the batteries are purchased within 1 month, which is fully charging separately and balancing your battery system before using them to maintain a constant voltage in the entire battery system. Next, the size of the PVC wire required should meet the requirements of the entire battery system. The user manual that comes with the battery will help you determine what size of PVC wire to choose. Please wear your insulation gloves throughout. Okay, now let's get started with parallel connections. For the parallel connection, we suggest using the copper busbar. It balances the input and output currents of each battery to protect connected terminals from heating up or even melting. During the connections, use the torque wrench with 12 to 14 Newton per meter to tighten all the bolts securely. Connect the negative terminals of batteries or to the copper busbar first. Next, connect the positive terminals of batteries to another copper busbar. Now we have finished the parallel connections with two 12-volt 100-amp batteries. You know, the parallel connections will increase the battery capacity and amperage. Let's measure the voltage. You can see the voltage is 13.1 volt now, so it is the 12-volt 200-amp battery system. Our battery supports parallel connections with multiple batteries, like the 12-volt 300-amp or 12-volt 400-amp battery system. If you want to connect more than 4 batteries in parallel for your special needs, please contact LiTime's customer service. Okay, now, let's show you how to connect the parallel connected battery system to charge and discharge equipment. We'll use the lithium charger as an example. Connect the negative output cable to this negative copper busbar, then connect the positive output cable to this positive copper busbar. Plug the end to the connector and then connect the charger to the grid. Once the charger is connected and start charging, you can see the power indicator turns from green to red. Now let's see the parallel connected battery system one more time. We recommend you to leave them alone for 12 to 24 hours for battery balancing before connecting them to your appliances. Next, we'll show you how to wire the batteries in series. Simply connect the cables between the negative terminal on this battery and the positive terminal on that battery. Tighten the bolts securely. Like this, we'll finish the series connection. So easy, right? Let's measure the voltage. We all know that the series connections will increase the voltage. You can see the voltage is 26.3 volts now. So this area is the 24-volt 100-amp battery system. Just repeat this step, you'll get the 36-volt 100-amp or the 51.2-volt 100-amp battery system. We suggest the voltage of the entire battery system should not exceed 51.2-volt. As mentioned earlier, it is much better to balance the batteries before using it. For the series connection, we recommend you use the balancer. Let's show you how to connect the balancer to the batteries. Connect this negative cable of the balancer to the battery's negative terminal. Then connect this positive cable of the balancer to the battery's positive terminal. Repeat the steps. Connect the other battery to the balancer. Okay, now, let's show you how to connect the series connected battery system to charge and discharge equipment. Likewise, we'll use the lithium charger as an example. First, we need to find which positive terminal and which negative terminal are not in series. As you can see, the negative terminal of this battery is not in series with the positive terminal of the other battery. So connect the negative output cable to this negative terminal, find the positive terminal that is not in series with the other battery. Okay, now we complete the connection. Then buckle the Anderson connector and connect it to the grid. Once the charger is connected and start charging, you can see the power indicator turns from green to red. Now you get the method of series and parallel connections and how to charge them. Next video, we'll show you how to connect the battery system with two parallel and two series connections. See you next time.